Hey Google, turn on TV. Today, we're going to take a look at the new Prism Plus QE Pro. Now, we're no strangers to Prism Plus. If you've seen from our other videos, we've reviewed the monitors, and especially when it comes to their TVs, we've seen the 55 and then the 75. And now, you know, I used to think the 75 was massive. Now, you've got an even bigger 86-inch TV. An 86-inch TV is probably one of the bigger sizes you're gonna get in the general consumer market. Typically, you're not gonna go beyond 75, and 86 to some might be overkill. Now, if you take a look at the 75-inch video that we did earlier, well, just standing here in terms of scale, that TV was probably around here. And now this is one that's, you know, it's actually bigger than I am. So it is a huge, massive TV. In comparison to the previous non-QE models, this is definitely brighter, better, much better contrast ratio than the non-QE versions. And that is what you get with the QE Pro series. That is the big differentiator. There aren't many differences between the technology between that and this, but I would say that has to be the biggest difference, and it's also one of the most important differences. One of the other differences is the fact that you now have a Google mic or a microphone integrated into the TV itself that allows it to be the nucleus of your smart home entertainment system or your smart home system if you didn't already previously have a microphone-enabled Google smart device. So it's built in right at the base of the TV. It does have a hard switch to turn it off if that's not what you want. But if you want it, it does everything basically where you used to speak into the mic. Now this far-field microphone that is integrated into the TV itself makes it a lot easier to access with something just like, hey Google, show me the latest movies. The next bit in terms of a technology upgrade would be the availability of Bluetooth 5. So the newer TVs, the new QE series uses the 5.0 standard that allows you to connect more Bluetooth devices to the TV than before. You also get greater range and faster transfer rate. So this is more important, or a lot more important, when you are trying to connect a soundbar and you want high quality audio to be transferred to that soundbar. I would recommend a soundbar. Now, it does have Dolby audio, which it can basically send out the signal. It's also supposed to have DTS surround sound, but with any TV, even the most high-end TVs, I always recommend an external sound system if you really want to enjoy your audio. This is a 4K TV, and one of the things about having such a big screen, firstly, it's a big screen, and I love my big screens. The bigger, the better. Everything is enlarged. You game, you watch football, it is really, really good. What I would recommend is wall mounting it, because this thing is huge. You want it as flat as possible on the wall, and you need space. In order to truly enjoy the 4K experience on a big screen TV, you should get some UHD, some Ultra HD 4K content delivered to the TV itself. If not, in some cases, it might end up looking worse than it would on a 55-inch TV or even a 75. Unfortunately, one of the things that has not changed, which we have been waiting for, is the HDMI 2.1 standard. So this still goes at a maximum of 60Hz, and basically that's the frame rate you can run. It's acceptable it's still not up to the next gen console gaming 120 hertz that you can get with HDMI 2.1. That is still one of the drawbacks of this TV. If you seriously were to compare, it is sharp, it is clear, it is not the best. And I don't think that's what Prism is aiming for. It's not the best class, it's not the best quality screen that you can get in the market. There are OLED TVs that are sharper, brighter, deeper blacks. Yes, they are there, they exist. In fact, check out Just Saying Asia, we just recently reviewed one of the best panels that I've ever seen. However, that being said, at 86 inches, and very much like the 75-inch TV, where I said that, you know, if you want the big TV experience, this is a price that can't be beat. This 86-inch TV goes for $3,199 Singapore dollars, and with everything that you get, it is still amazing value. For an OLED TV with the latest technology, you can easily spend more than $10,000-$11,000. That is a huge, huge, huge price gap. If the best panel was a 10 out of 10, I would give this a 8 out of 10. And those two extra points are heavily justified by the difference in price point. So unless you've got the money to go for just the best of the best of the best of the best, and you're willing to basically break the bank and spend all of that, this is now my favorite TV and the best bet for that big TV experience. Thank you for watching another video from Just Saying Asia. Please, if you like our content, like the page, like us, subscribe, and leave a comment. We really want to hear what you have to say, and we'll be happy to answer your comments and your questions as well. So stay tuned and see you in the next video.